in the nafs, so you need to work hard to get rid of it. That's why Abu Bakr as-Siddiq radiallahu anhu, when he heard this hadith from the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he felt on his knees radiallahu anhu. He felt on his knees and he said, "Oh Prophet of Allah, tell me what to do." Imagine, this is Abu Bakr as-Siddiq radiallahu anhu, who received the news from the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam that you are going to be with me in Jannah, and yet he trembled. He was afraid that he might fall into this particular sin, the riya or shirk, very subtle shirk or inconspicuous shirk, something it's very hard to feel it and detect it. So he said, "What should I do, O Prophet of Allah?" The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he taught us a dua. So every Muslim should memorize this dua. This dua says what? Allahumma inni a'udhu bika min an ushrika bika shay'an wa ana a'lam wa astaghfiruka lima la a'lam. O Allah, I seek protection in you, that I might associate any partner with you knowingly, and I seek your protection and forgiveness from associating any partner with you without knowledge. So this dua is so important. Memorize it and keep saying it in your sujood all the time. When you do something, say this dua. So may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala save all of us from falling into this form of riya. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he taught us a dua. So every Muslim should memorize this dua. This dua says what? Allahumma inni a'udhu bika min an ushrika bika shay'an wa ana a'lam wa astaghfiruka lima la a'lam. O Allah, I seek protection in you, that I might associate any partner with you knowingly, and I seek your protection and forgiveness from associating any partner with you without knowledge. So this dua is so important. Memorize it and keep saying it in your sujood all the time. When you do something, say this dua. So may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala save all of us from falling into this form of riya. Now we are going to, inshallah, study together and some aspects or various aspects, different forms of showing off. The riya or showing off can be manifested in different forms. Riya, my dear brothers and sisters, or showing off, can be manifested in different, it has many forms and shades. Among these different aspects of riya, for instance, the niyyah, the intention is not purely for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, but for the people. So you do things, so the motivation is only that you want to get the pleasure of the people, that the people are pleased with you. How's it? Fine, good, excellent, you like it? Good, that makes you feel happy, that's it. Not that Allah is happy with you, not that Allah is pleased with you. So always what bothers you, what preoccupies your mind, is only the people's pleasure, not your Lord's pleasure. This is very dangerous. What the people can do for you? Nothing. The people will not enter with you your grave. And you are going to face all these things by yourself. You can deceive anyone, but you cannot deceive your Lord. You cannot deceive your Creator, who knows everything. And you are going to meet Him. And He is going to ask you, "Why didn't you do this for me?" He says, "I did it, not for me. I know what was in your heart. I know what was your motivation. You cannot deceive me. You cannot deceive Allah Azza wa Jal." So this actually reflects the foolishness of the person who shows off. Anyone who shows off is a fool. Why? Because you are a loser. The people can do nothing for you. Do things purely, exclusively for Allah, and then you will get the reward in the second life. Listen, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He rebukes the hypocrites, because that is hypocrisy. That is what we call nifaq. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in Surah An-Nisa, Surah number 4, Ayah 142, إِنَّ الْمُنَافِقِينَ يُخَادِعُونَ اللَّهَ وَهُوَ خَادِعُهُمْ وَإِذَا قَامُوا إِلَى الصَّلَاةِ قَامُوا كُسَالَى يُرَاءُونَ النَّاسَ وَلَا يَذْكُرُونَ اللَّهَ إِلَّا قَلِيلًا. Subhanallah. Verily the hypocrites, when they get up, they try to beguile and deceive the people. But they deceive no one but themselves. And when they get up to the salah, the hypocrites, at the time of the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, munafiqeen, those who pretended to be Muslims, but in reality they are not. So when they get up to pray to the salah, they get up to the salah while they are in a state of laziness. يُرَاءُونَ النَّاسِ. يُرَاءُونَ النَّاسِ, that they do these things that in order to be seen by the people. وَلَا يَذْكُرُونَ اللَّهَ إِلَّا قَلِيلًا. And they hardly mention Allah. So what will happen to them? Subhana Rabbil Azim. What will happen to them? Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told us. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told us. Allah says, إِنَّ الْمُنَافِقِينَ فِي الدَّرْكِ الْأَسْفَلِ مِنَ النَّارِ. The hypocrites, those who pretended to be Muslims, but in reality they are not, what will happen to them? They are in the lowest part of the hellfire. فِي الدَّرْكِ الْأَسْفَلِ مِنَ النَّارِ. Also Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam tells us in the hadith, which is in Sahih Muslim, that he said about the prayer of the hypocrite, a person who delays his salah. My dear brothers and sisters, never delay your salah. Never. Pray on time. Wherever you are, even in the office, you have no place to pray, next to your desk, put your prayer mat and pray. But never miss your salah. Because some people, they delay dhuhr until asr, and asr until maghrib, and maghrib until isha. That is the salah of the munafiq, Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is saying. That is the prayer of the hypocrite. He waits till the sun is about to set between the two horns of shaitan. He stands up and prays four rak'ah quickly. So this is the salah of the munafiq. He delays the salah until the sun is about to set. Then he hurries up and pray them quickly. As a matter of fact, he said, becking them like the craw when it is becking and the blood. And he hardly mentions Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Now, riya, my dear brothers and sisters, there are different scenarios where the riya can come to the picture. For instance, you initially started doing it for Allah Azza wa Jal. You do the good deed for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But then the shaitan starts to whisper to you, so you start now to do it not for the sake of Allah Azza wa Jal. Like what? Like the salah. You started your salah, Allahu Akbar, and you mean to pray for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And you finish the first unit of prayer. You finished it. In the second unit, or the second rak'ah, you started going to ruku' and sujood, and you are starting now, you are prolonging the ruku'. Ruku' is the, when you are in the bowing position. Sujood is in the prostration. So you started prolonging the ruku' and the sujood, because now someone is watching you. Someone is watching you, so you started to prolong the salah. So now there is riya, there is showing off. So this now will cancel the salah, and Allah will not accept it from you. Though you started praying for the sake of Allah, but now you started prolonging the salah for showing off. So this salah will be cancelled and Allah will not accept it from you. The second, that you started initially doing it for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, but in the process of doing this ibadah, doing this good deed, like for instance your prayer, in the second rak'ah the showing off crept on. So you started doing it for showing off. Here,